Hey, what's going on, tech fans? Chances are you know what FreeSync and G-Sync is. If you don't, then stick around and watch this video because I'm going to explain exactly what FreeSync is and what the different versions of FreeSync are. So between 2014 and 2015, AMD decided they wanted to compete with G-Sync, which is basically variable rate refresh technology. So they invented FreeSync. Now FreeSync was a free solution. You didn't have to pay anything extra. G-Sync, you paid a little bit more money. But FreeSync Basic was what came out first, and then they had FreeSync 2. But now the names have kind of changed around a little bit, and the technology has changed as well. So let's talk about why FreeSync is cool and what the different versions of FreeSync are. Let's talk tech. Did you just build yourself a brand new PC? Or did you just upgrade your old PC, but find you're in need of a Windows 10 key? If that's the case, your CD key has you covered. And buying, it's never been easier. All you do is go to your CD key website, find the Windows software that you want to buy, put it into your cart, enter the code TOT20, apply the code, save yourself some extra money, and as soon as you complete your purchase, the Windows 10 key will be in your inbox. There's no problems, it's really easy, and all keys are guaranteed to work, so you don't have to worry about losing your money, and you'll have a valid Windows 10 key to get your unit up and running. So FreeSync Basic was the very first FreeSync that ever came out. It was actually designed for 60 hertz monitors. It would work with monitors up to 120 hertz, but it was just a basic feature of FreeSync. It wasn't actually as good as full-blown hardware G-Sync, but once again, it was free. It supported variable rate refresh technology, and you know, it would basically make it so your screen didn't tear, you got better gaming, but it wasn't the absolute best solution. So AMD actually ditched the name FreeSync 2. FreeSync 2 now became FreeSync Pro. So what exactly is FreeSync Pro? Well, FreeSync Pro is actually a better version of FreeSync. And as you go up the different tiers, the technology and the sophistication behind the technology keeps growing and growing. So really the big thing with FreeSync Premium is, let's just say that you have a monitor that's 144 hertz monitor, but all of a sudden the frame rates drop. Well, with FreeSync Pro, it's going to make sure that you are locked in at 120 hertz. In fact, for FreeSync Pro, unless you have a monitor that's 1920 by 1080 and supports up to 120 hertz minimum, you won't even see that technology on the monitor whatsoever. Currently, however, with 4K monitors, this limitation of 144, 120 hertz, it doesn't really count whatsoever. With 4K technology currently, they're focused more on higher visual fidelity and higher, you know, resolutions than they really are with just a bunch of massive frame rates. So another thing that you get with FreeSync Premium is what's called, you know, low frame rate compensation. You guys are going, what the heck is that? Well, low frame rate compensation means that when your video card drops below a certain threshold, there are added frames to make sure that the card and the monitor are still talking to each other completely correctly and that your gaming experience doesn't get affected whatsoever. So it's not gonna be playing your game and all of a sudden, oh my God, what the heck's going on here? No, you will be saved. And also another thing to note is that with FreeSync Basic, you do not get low frame rate compensation whatsoever. That technology doesn't go with that particular thing. Now, the next tier is FreeSync Premium Pro. Now, FreeSync Premium Pro has everything that's good about FreeSync Premium, but you also get full support for HDR. And here's something that I would really like to note. You know, If you're looking for a monitor right now and you're out there, there's so many to choose from. I probably would not get a monitor at this point in time that just has FreeSync Basic unless that's really all you can afford and you really don't want to have the better technology. But with all of the games and new things that are coming out that are, you know, have HDR, I mean, come on, almost everything you're watching on TV, half your games you're playing now and stuff have HDR. So why not have a monitor that has HDR technology, right? I mean, that's pretty smart move. So if you're out really looking for a monitor, I would really look for Premium or Premium Pro. And if it was me buying a monitor, I would really try to look around for a Premium Pro supported monitor. Now, a Premium Pro supported monitor, I think, is pretty much on the same level as hardware G-Sync. Everybody knows that hardware G-Sync is a really great solution for, you know, playing your games without losing any frame rates, without losing any of your, you know, the game playing and tearing and making the screen look all crappy. I mean, basically FreeSync or G-Sync, all it really does is really just make sure that when you're playing your game, that you're not dropping out of the frames that you're playing, your screen is not tearing, you're not getting any weird artifacts in the game. It just makes it so that your monitor and your video card talk to each other completely and make your video game experience a lot better. Now, another thing to take note of, if you have a newer system and the video card that you have and the monitor that you have already support DisplayPort 1.4 or HDMI 2.0, then guess what? You're already getting variable rate refresh stuff already on your system. The whole thing is that with G-Sync and FreeSync, you get a lot of added benefit and a lot of different things. I mean, even though with, you know, DisplayPort 1.4 or HDMI 2.1, you're going to be able to have that technology. It's a basic technology, and yeah, your games are going to look better. And the way technology is going, I would imagine that in a few years down the line, that both FreeSync and G-Sync are going to be something that we talk about in the past tense. But as it is right now, if you're going out and you're looking for a monitor, you have an AMD card, and you want a really good FreeSync monitor, then I would definitely try to look around for one that's either Premium or Premium Pro. I would really try to avoid the basic entry model. If that's all you can get, then cool. You'll still get, you know, some of the technology. It's just not the absolute best solution. So if you're somebody out there, you want to know about what's going on with this stuff, I hope I explained it well. There are three tiers. It's really simple. Basic, Premium, Premium Pro. Really the differences is, basic is like it says, a basic model. Premium, you get a lot better support. If your frame rates drop before 144 hertz on your monitor, you'll be locked in at 120, so you're still not going to get any blurring or anything like that. And if you get Premium Pro, you get all that goodness and support for HDR as well, which is the future. So I'm Elric. You guys have been watching Tech of Tomorrow. I thank you for your viewership. Hey, if you like what you see, I'd love to see you sub to the channel. Hit that sub button and make sure you turn on that notification bell. Ding! Or you won't even know I'm making videos. So peace out. If you'd like to support the channel and don't have any money, I've got a link down below where you guys can click on it for Amazon Prime. Try it for free. Just use my link and it gives me credit and it keeps the channel around. So peace out. And for a single dollar, you can support us on Patreon as well. So I'm out of here. We'll see you guys back here for more tech on Tech of Tomorrow.